Good afternoon, and welcome to the Illinois Tollways Diversity Webinar Series. The Tollways commitment to diversity and inclusion is unrivaled, and setting the conditions necessary for a level playing field requires commitment, outreach, and education, and an industry receptive to change for the greater good. Continuing to learn more about your trade, profession, and skills puts you at a competitive advantage. And through the Diversity Webinar Series, our goal is to present you with various topics that will help you be successful in your business and tollway work. At any time, you can access our webinars on the Tollways website. There you will discover over 60 webinars that will help you learn how to do business with the tollway, become a better business, or embark on a new and exciting career in the heavy highway construction industry. Now, before we get started, let's go over a couple of housekeeping rules that will help us engage more efficiently with you. All of the attendees will be muted. If you have any questions, please enter them into the chat box and they will be answered during the question and answer portion of the webinar. In addition, these webinars are being recorded for future use and can be accessed by visiting the Tollways Diversity webpage. Today's webinar topic is navigating BidBuy. Joining me today is Jennifer Soldat. She's the Illinois Tollway Senior Procurement Training Specialist. And unfortunately, we did have Dave Littrell from the State of Illinois Procurement Office for General Services, and he's not able to join us, but we do plan on doing this webinar one more time in the near future. And we will have him attend and walk us through the BidBuy website, how to register, and how to navigate that page. But for now, let's go ahead and see what Jen has to share with us. Let me go ahead and give you some sharing privilege.
Thank you, Lorena. Good afternoon, everybody. Hope everyone's having a great Monday afternoon. I go ahead and share here. As Lorena said, my name is Jennifer Soldat. I'm the Senior Procurement Training Specialist for the Goods and Services Department at the Illinois Tollway. And thank you for attending Building for Success, Navigating BidBuy. We're going to talk about some things today. How does the Illinois Tollway utilize BidBuy? Required documents for bid submission, how to avoid common mistakes, and questions. So how does the Illinois Tollway utilize BidBuy? BidBuy is the state of Illinois' e-procurement system utilized by the agencies under the Chief Procurement Officer of General Services. So what does that mean? It means that all agencies under the Chief Procurement Officer of General Services are required to utilize BidBuy in order to request bids or proposals from vendors. So we are required to utilize BidBuy for all procurements. So anything from $2,000 purchase order up into a multi-million dollar order for trucks or for rock salt. Currently, the Illinois Tollway is only accepting electronic bids through BidBuy. That is due to the pandemic. So we are no longer accepting paper bids and bids via fax or email. So in order to submit a bid to Illinois Tollway, you will have to be registered in BidBuy to do so. Procurement opportunities and awards are listed for the public to view on the BidBuy website where there is no login required. So that is public information. You're welcome to log in. But like I said before, in order to actually submit a bid or an offer, you must be registered in BidBuy to do so. How do we utilize BidBuy? So the Illinois Tollway currently utilizes BidBuy to solicit opportunities for bids and also post notices of contracts awards for our three different departments. So we have goods and services. Goods and services are commodities like rock salt, roadway materials, vehicles, office supplies, software licenses. Services can include anything from temporary staffing services, IT consulting services, and repair services. Our construction contracts, which are let through the IFB process. So those would be all of our construction projects. And then also our professional service bulletins, which you may hear referred to as PSBs. Those can be for general engineering consultant, traffic engineering consultant, program management office contracts, design contracts, construction management, and other specialty services such as surveying, geotechnical engineering, environmental studies, etc. So in a nutshell, all of the tollways contracts advertised in BidBuy, and we are required to accept bids and offers through BidBuy. So how does one register in BidBuy? So there are two facets to this. If your company is already registered in the Illinois Procurement Gateway, a BidBuy registration will have already been started for you. You would have received an email with your BidBuy login credentials, and you'll simply need to complete the registration by creating a username and password on the BidBuy website. If your company is not registered in BidBuy, and you didn't register in the IPG, you'll need to register in the IPG as well. So the interface works from IPG to BidBuy. It does not work from BidBuy to the IPG. I hope that makes sense. Happy to answer questions about that later. When you do register in BidBuy, you want to ensure to register under NIGP codes that match your company's interests. Bids are advertised utilizing NIGP codes that correspond to the topic of the solicitation. So if your company is registered under that NIGP code in BidBuy, you will receive an email notification inviting your company to submit a bid or a proposal, which is called a quote in BidBuy terminology. If you are not registered in BidBuy, you can still view that opportunity on the BidBuy website. But like I said before, you do have to be registered to submit a response. So just because you didn't receive the email doesn't mean you can't submit a response. As long as it's publicly available on the BidBuy website, you can go ahead and submit a response. The only caveat to this, small business set aside procurements. Certain procurements are set aside for small businesses only. So you would have to be a small business registered under that NIGP code in order to submit a bid. And now we're just going to take some time to go over some required documents for bid submissions, for goods solicitations, and then we'll look at for PSBs. This is really important because this goes hand in hand with BidBuy when you're submitting a quote. You do want to make sure that when you're utilizing the system, you do return all the required information to be considered responsive. If you don't, then unfortunately we cannot consider your bid responsive, and then you won't be considered for award. So good point is always refer to the specific solicitation documents for a complete listing of all the documents required to be returned with the bidder or proposal. Bidders must complete, sign, upload all required documents with their quote and BidBuy to be considered responsive. A change that we have seen to the system by the CPO's office, there are now required document questions in the bids and BidBuy for IFBs and RFPs that require you to submit an attachment for the specific need. So there is one for a signed contract. There's one for a utilization plan. There's one for Forms A or Forms B. And that's really to help you, the vendor, to ensure that you're attaching all the required documents for that bid to be considered responsive. But I will say this, please ensure to read the solicitation documents because the requirements can change from bid to bid. So just because you've responded to one IFB doesn't mean the requirements may necessarily be the same for the next IFB. At a minimum, some of the typically required documents are correct. So yes, even though you are submitting in BidBuy, we still do require that signed contract, the actual form with a signature, pricing, Forms A or Forms B. Bidders must have a valid IPG registration number to submit Forms B, a BEP utilization plan, bid or performance bond, a BOE registration for $50,000 and over, that's Board of Elections registration, and SOS registration, which is Secretary of State registration for formal solicitations. So again, ensure to review the solicitation documents completely and return all the required documents with the bid, offer, submission, and bid by. And this is another point I can't stress enough, and I'll definitely stress on to. Late submittals are not accepted, okay? Whether you can't access the system, you started late, you weren't able to finish on time. So that's why we really do stress to ensure to start your quote and bid by well in advance of the due date and time to allow for troubleshooting. And then we will get into the contact information later on for who to contact if you're experiencing issues. But just keep in mind that electronic system, so you might think, oh, 5 minutes is enough time to do this, but you can never account for internet issues or if the system is experiencing high traffic or anything like that. So please, please, please remember to submit your bids on time. And then here are required documents for the professional services bulletins. Some of them look, these are additional documents include statements of interest to submit one per item proposed, the firm's commitment and signature form, Exhibit A, proposed staff, Exhibit B, location design studies, environmental questionnaire if applicable, Exhibit C, current obligations, Exhibit D, availability of key project personnel, Exhibit E, partnering for growth, a program if applicable, VOSB, SDVOSB for veterans, utilization plan and letter of intent, contract participation, past DBE, VOSB and BEP participation, and Exhibit H, DBE utilization plan and letter of intent. For DBEs, disadvantaged business enterprises, and VOSBs, the veteran-owned small business, current proof of certification is required along with your U plan. And then those forms A or forms B, certifications and disclosures forms. And then also for PSBs that are submitted, required to be submitted in eBuilder, the SOI team data. And then lastly, we want to talk about avoiding common mistakes. Again, just because you're submitting in BidBuy electronically, we want to make sure that you're still returning all the required documents that we just talked about. So you're going to want to read solicitations in detail and include all required forms. Remember, just because you submitted an IFB last week doesn't mean you have to submit the same documents. The requirements may change from to solicitation. You also have to complete those required financial disclosures and conflict interest forms, standard certifications, and TIN page. Either forms A or forms B must be submitted. We can talk about that more if you guys have questions during the Q&A period. I'm happy to address that. Any delinquent debt prior to submitting an offer, so bidders or offers with delinquent debt of $1,000 outstanding 90 days or more with no established payment plan will render the bidder or offer non-responsive. So please do make sure to resolve any delinquent debt prior to submitting your bid or offer. Electronic bids still require that signed offer along with applicables to be uploaded. So remember, just because you're submitting electronically in BidBuy, you still do have to have that signed document. If a solicitation contains a BEP or a DBE and or veteran goal, that U plan must be submitted along with certification. So get BEP veteran certified or DBE certified and stay current. You do have to certify on an annual basis. Bid opportunities are price competitive. So remember that. And again, I'll sound like a broken record here, guys, but please, please, please submit on time. Start your submission well in advance. You can always in BidBuy quote and come back to it. That way you can do what you can when you can. And then if you're still waiting on pricing, competitive pricing from like a subcontractor or something like that, you can always add that in. But we do want to make sure that you're in the system, you're with the system, and you time to ask questions if needed. So I cannot stress that point enough. So questions, tollway specific questions. If you have the specific solicitation, the content in the solicitation that's advertised by, you're going to contact the solicitation contact for each individual. You will see in BidBuy, there's an area, I believe it's called info contact. You will see the tollway representative's name there, and then also their phone number and or email. So please, if you have questions, contact them directly. Do not contact, say, the Tollway's compliance department, diversity department. It is an open procurement, so the only entity you should be contacting is the solicitation contact in Tollway procurement. They are the only ones who can respond to your question. If it is about the solicitation. Now, if you're having BidBuy system specific questions, please contact the BidBuy vendor help desk. I believe Lorena will watch these slides as part of the presentation. So I have listed the email and the phone number of the BidBuy vendor help desk for you all. You can go ahead and access that. They do, I believe they are Monday through Friday, probably 8 to 4. So, make sure to call between those hours. Give them a call, give them an email. They'll get back to you with system specific issues. We at the Tollway, it's not our system. So as much as we would love to talk you through how to do something in BidBuy, oftentimes we can't. So definitely give yourself enough time to be able to reach the appropriate people and to ask your question. And that is all that I have for this. If we want, we can go through the CPO's website and I can show you the BidBuy homepage. I can show you the BidBuy homepage and then some helpful links, if that will help. And I saw your question, Kristen. I'll get to that. Okay. So here is the Illinois BidBuy homepage. You can see up here it says BidBuy Illinois Procurement. You can see up here that we have a search bar. So that is where you can search for bid solicitations and master contracts. This David Littrell will be joining us at a future date to show exactly how to register and how to submit bids. I'll give you a brief overview here. If you do not registration in the Illinois Procurement Gateway and you want to join BidBuy, you just click register in the top right corner. You would enter in your tax ID. If you are an individual or a sole proprietor, you would enter your social security number. So there's a toggle right here. Enter in your company name, your email address, and your location, and you can register. Okay. I believe that's also where you go to. Actually, that's not. If you are given an email from the IPG when you register, you go to sign in and type in your credentials there that they would have given you, and then you can finish your account there. If you look at the BidBuy's homepage, as you scroll down here, beautiful photo by POs. And then as you scroll down, you can see here that there is no charge for vendors to register in BidBuy. So that's great to note. Here it does give you a note here that new vendors, if your business is registered in the IPG, your account has been created. And then here it does say choose the log system access below. The vendor help desk is also here. Okay, 8:30 to 4:30. So those are the hours. You can always access them there. And then under supplier activities here, you can complete your registration if you had started in the IPG. You can view open bid opportunities here. So that's what we do for. You can look at open bids without a registration. And you can also look at active blankets, and those are master contracts by the CPO's office, or I'm sorry, CPO's office, CMS, and do it. And then down here, you are going to see some important links. And these are great for first-time users. And Dave will walk us through this in the future. But how to register and bid by guides and videos, super helpful. Locating statewide master contracts. The pathway to procurement website, which will have all the vendor information for you in order to complete your registration and bid by. And then here, vendors, reasons your bid or offer may be deemed non-responsive. And then this is important down here. I'm not going to click on it because it's a YouTube video, but the new feature that we have for RFPs are going to be the pricing lockbox. And the required quote attachment. So that's something brand new that we've had to ensure pricing isn't opened, the technical response has been done. And then also the required quote attachments is what I talked about before, to help the vendors, help you guys to ensure that you have attached the required attachments in the areas you're supposed to. So whereas BidBuy, you would just have to upload attachments, now there's actually questions in BidBuy that says, upload your signed contract. Did you upload A? Did you upload your forms B? So that's definitely helpful. I will caution this. Please ensure that you are uploading the correct attachment into each question. We have seen sometimes where vendors may accidentally name an attachment wrong, and then they attach and a Forms A accidentally got saved as a BEPU plan, or the signed contract accidentally got saved as Forms A. So please double and triple check your attachments in BidBuy to what you know is actually contained in those files. Ensure that the title matches the contents as well. So I think I'll stop sharing at this point and we can open up the floor for some questions.
That's right. Thanks, Jen. Let me get back my screen.
Thank you, Jen. You did a great job.
Terry.
Alrighty. So thanks again, Jen, for giving us such great information, filling in and giving us a brief overview for Dave's portion. Like Jen and I both said, we will be doing this in the near future when we can identify a date and go through the same presentation and make sure that Dave has an opportunity to walk us through step by step on how to work that BidBuy website. Aside from that, Jen had a lot of really good information that's totally related. So thank you for that. We are now open for questions. We have been receiving a couple of questions during your actual presentation. And I do want to remind the audience that the webinar is being recorded and it will be posted to the webinar series page along with this PowerPoint presentation. So if you have any question for Jen, please go ahead and enter it into the chat box now and we can start addressing those. The first question that I see, do you want to start with yours, Jen? Because they may have sent you a private one that I don't see.
Yeah, I have one private question about clarifying that the PSB is not submitted in BidBuy. The PSBs, I believe, are submitted in eBuilder, I believe. I can gain some clarification on that for you. The bid opportunities are submitted in BidBuy, and then which are let through like an IFB procurement approach. And the PSBs are done via the QSB, the qualification, QBS qualification. So I believe those are done in eBuilder, but I can get some more clarification for that if you guys would like.
Thank you, Jen.
And that's that's the only question I got privately. So it's all, the floor is for you, Lorena.
Okay. So the first question I got is, what is BOE registration? It was something you mentioned during your presentation, Board of Elections. Just not sure what this means, especially for an out-of-state company.
Yeah, so companies to do business in the state of Illinois are required to register with the Illinois State Board of Elections. So that's what BOE stands for, Board of Elections. And if you're doing more than $50,000 worth of business in Illinois, that's combined. It's not just tollway or with IDOT or with $50,000 or more annually, your company is required to register with the Illinois State Board of Elections. So you would have an elections website and your company would have to register. And what that does, it ensures that your company is not making any campaign contributions to those parties who are in charge of making entering into contracts for the state of Illinois and for the tollway specifically. So basically what we do is before we're going to award a contract, we look at the board actions, we look at your registration, and we ensure that you're not contributing to the campaign for the party who's ultimately ultimately responsible for signing tollway contracts, which in our case would be the governor and the lieutenant governor. If we see that, that's a conflict of interest. People would basically accuse a company of padding pockets, and we don't want that, right? We want everything to be on the up and up. So if we do research the Board of Elections registration for a specific company and find that, we have to then take it to our state purchasing officer and our chief procurement officer, and then it goes through a process to repay those funds. So if you are out of state, you still do have to register. The registration should be fairly painless, but you are required to list your company and then any executive membership, so your president, your vice president, secretary, treasurer of the company, any affiliates, to ensure that contributions.
Thank you so much.
That was probably a longer answer than you needed, but
no, I even just learned something from that, so thank you for sharing all of that.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay, I have another question here. Are bids or RFP result posted in BidBuy? If yes, where are they posted?
So that's a two-pronged answer. So the as-reds are different from the actual notices of award. So on the actual day of the bid opening, we will post our as-read results for IFBs, and then whoever submitted for an RFP, we'll post those directly on the Tollway's website. Not until we go through, say, a responsiveness review, where we ensure that the vendor is compliant with their Secretary of State, their Board of Election, their Illinois Department of Human Rights registration. Were they responsive to every facet of the bid? Did they disclosures? Did they submit all required documents? After we receive approval, we will go ahead and post that notice of award in BidBuy to that specific bid. So you can always go back to that bid and check to see if a notice of award has been published. So only then will you actually know which vendor has been awarded. So keep in mind that even though we read red results, that might not be who's not awarded.
Thank you. I have one more question here. If you're trying to go after a solicitation, but you don't have that NIGP code in the IPG, would I go back into the IPG and add the NIGP code before I submit a quote into BidBuy?
So that's a good question. You do not have to be registered under the NIGP code in the IPG or in BidBuy in order to submit a response. But being registered under that NIGP code will allow the system to email you of that opportunity. So if I am registered under the, if I'm not registered under the NIGP code for, let's say, hazardous waste removal, okay, but I go on and I see, and my company is a hazardous waste company, and I see that there's a IFB out there for an opportunity, I can submit on it. I can register and bid by, I can submit a bid in response to it. I don't have to be registered under that NIGP code to submit the response. I just need registered under that NIGP code to get the email notification that there is an opportunity available. Now, the only time this makes a difference, like I had said before, is for small business set-aside procurements. Those are certain procurements that are either under the small purchase, which is currently $105,600, or that are in the, I think it's 673 categories that are set aside for small business participation, regardless of dollar threshold. And in that case, your company would have to be registered under that
system.
You've been done though during your small business registration. Yeah. I'm sorry?
You're breaking up,
Terry?
A little bit, Jen.
Do you want me to repeat? I don't know where I broke up at.
Just a little bit near the end, that might help. And if it helps turn off the camera, that, you know, you could do that too.
I'll do that. So sorry if you didn't hear that. But basically, if you're a business who registered and is classified as a small business in the Illinois Procurement Gateway, you would have already been registered on GP codes. You are to be a small business who is registered. So you won't really need to worry about being registered under the correct codes, if that makes sense, for those specific procurements that are set aside. But I just want to mention that because sometimes people say, well, why can't I see this procurement? It's because there are sometimes those procurements that are set aside only for businesses. I hope that makes sense.
Yeah, thank you so much. Appreciate that. And thank you for repeating, because you did break up a little bit. Thanks, Terry, for pointing that out.
Sorry, Terry. Thank you.
No problem. Thank you.
It looks like I just have one more question, and it's in regards to the recording. So I can go ahead and take that one. We will be posting this to the webinar series page. I'll put the link here in the chat box. It'll probably be up by tomorrow morning. It'll be the full recording of this, as well as the presentation that Jen shared with us. But as always, if you guys have any questions, feel free to send me an email, and I'm happy to answer or field your questions. With that said, I will go ahead and close off this webinar. And, you know, again, thank you to the audience for attending. You guys had some great questions. Makes this really engaging when you guys submit and are listening and taking a lot of the material that's being presented. Because if you have a question, most likely somebody else that's listening has the same question. Please feel free to visit the Illinois Tollway website, click under Doing Business, and then under Diversity to discover how you can participate in our programs. Make sure you go to the Tollway's website to learn more about the resources that are available to you through the Diversity programs. We appreciate your support and participation on these weekly webinars. And in a couple weeks, we'll have another one. So look out for the invite. And before we log off, let me just go ahead and enter my email. If you have any questions, feel free to contact me. Otherwise, thank you so much and have a great rest of your Monday afternoon.
Thanks, everyone.